Today we are going to talk about SST, SSE, and SSR. But before we discuss them, we need to know some algebraic properties of the OLS estimator. And the first property of the OLS estimator is the sum and the sample average of the OLS residual is zero. And we can write that as summation of ui hat is equals to zero. The second property of the OLS estimator is the sample covariance between the regressors and the OLS residual is always going to be zero. And we can write that as summation of xi multiplied by ui hat is equals to zero. Third property of the OLS estimator is the mean point of x and y is always going to lie on the OLS regression line. And we can see that from the equation of beta naught hat. We know that beta naught hat is equals to y bar minus beta 1 hat multiplied by x bar. And we can rearrange this equation and write it as y bar is equals to beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat x bar. So this is a regression equation, and we can see from this equation that y bar and x bar is lying on the OLS regression line. And the fourth property of the OLS estimator is that the sample covariance between fitted value and residual is always going to be zero. And we can also say that as the fitted value and the residual are not correlated to each other. And we can express that with the covariance formula between the residual and the fitted value. So this is summation of u hat multiplied by yi hat minus y bar divided by n minus 1 is equals to 0. Now we are going to talk about SST, SSE, and SSR. SST is the total sum of squares, SSE is the explained sum of squares, and SSR is sum of squared residual. SST measures the total sample variation in the yi. It measures how spread out the yi are in the sample. And the SSE measures the sample variation in the yi hat, since it is the explained sum of squares. And the SSR measures the sample variation in the residual, as in the ui hat. So we can denote these things with equations. So since SST measures the total sample variation in the yi, we can write that as summation of I equals to 1 to n yi minus y bar whole square. So this measures how much yi varies from the mean in the sample. In the same way, SSE can be denoted as summation of yi hat minus y bar whole square, as in how much it varies from the mean. And in the same way, SSR can be denoted as summation of ui hat square. And this could be written as ui hat minus u bar whole square. But since the mean of the error term or residual is zero, so we are only left with summation of ui hat square. And SST is equals to SSE plus SSR. So we can see all this in a graph. So let's assume that we have many data points here. So these are all data points in the sample. Okay. So if we fit a regression line through here, so we are fitting a regression line through here, and this is the fitted value. So we are going to label it as yi hat. And the average value of these data points are going to be here, a straight line, and this is going to be y bar. So let's take a random data points, for example here. So these are all random data points, and these are all yi. So I'm just going to take a particular data point here, and let's say this is yi. Okay, so the variation, let me choose a different color here. So the variation of yi or the deviation from yi from the mean y bar would be the SST or the total sum of squares. So if we draw a line here, so the distance from y bar to this point would be what is SST. So this is SST. And we can write it as yi minus y bar whole square. And the explained sum of square, or the SSE, is the deviation of the fitted value yi hat from the mean value. So here, this right here is the yi hat, or the fitted value. So how much this deviate from the mean y bar is going to be expressed as SSE, or the explained sum of squares. And we can write it as yi hat minus y bar whole square. And the SSR is the sum of squared residual. So, and we know the squared residual is the difference between yi and yi hat. So the distance from here and here, let me pick a different color here so that would be more understandable. So the difference between yi and yi hat would be the sum of squared residual. So the actual data point is in here and the fitted value is here. So the distance here would be the SSR, or it is yi minus yi hat whole square, or we can simply just write it as ui hat square. Okay, now we're going to prove that SST is equals to SSE plus SSR. So we know that SST is equal to summation of yi minus y bar whole square. So to this equation, I'm going to add a minus yi hat and also a plus yi hat. So both of these will just cancel each other out. So ultimately, the effect is the same. So by adding this, we are getting yi minus yi hat plus y hat minus y bar and whole square. So we know that yi minus yi hat is equals to ui hat. So we are getting summation of ui hat plus yi hat minus y bar whole square. So we are just going to apply the formula of a plus b whole square here, and we are getting summation of ui hat square plus 2 summation of ui hat multiplied by yi hat minus y bar plus summation of yi hat minus y bar whole square. And we know that ui hat square is the SSR, and we're going to leave it as it is. And we also know that yi hat minus y bar whole square is SSE. So we are getting this line here. And remember, the fourth property of the OLS assumption is the sample covariance between the fitted value and residual are zero. So we already talked about this equation here. So if we multiply both sides by n minus one, we are going to be left with summation of u hat multiplied by yi hat minus y bar is equals to zero. So this is going to be zero. And if this is zero, this whole thing is zero. And so we are left with SSR plus SSE. So it's proved that SST is equals to SSE plus SSR.